We have already done the most important part, so I'm going to share my screen over here. The part which we discussed in the last class was all about what were the causes responsible for the growth of revolutionary nationalism or activities. These revolutionary activities were also related with the nationalistic aspirations of the young, frustrated youth of the country. Because these people were very much frustrated going through the moderate aims and objectives, and then the second phase, that was the radical nationalists, also could not achieve any success. That is why they thought that they need to instill fear in the minds of the hated British officers. For Anusilan, Samiti and Jugantar. So those part which we have already done in the previous class. So today we'll discuss a very small part of this chapter, that is the formation. How was Anusilan Samiti formed, or how was Jugantar group formed? Okay. So mostly this activity started from Bengal, and later on it spread to different parts of the country also. Okay. You can see here that in 1902 in Midnapore district of Bengal. That means Jainendra Nath Basu. Okay, so this is the name. That is Jainendra Nath Basu started a revolutionary society. He started a society. The main aim of the society was to kill the hated British officers and all. Okay, so this was done by Jainendra Nath Basu. You can underline it if you have the book. In the same year, in the gymnasium of Scottish Church College. At that time, it was known as General Assembly's Institution. General Assembly's Institution. Okay. General Assembly's Institution. You can see here. General Assembly Institution. Okay. So, a secret society was formed there also. In two places. Okay. That was in Bengal, Midnapore district of Bengal. It was started by Jainendra Nath Basu. And in the same place, like General Assembly's Institution, another secret society was formed, okay? And Barrister P.N. Mitra, Barrister P.N. Mitra, you can see here, P.N. Mitra became its president. A.N. Mitra became its president, okay? This center was later on shifted to Madan Mitra Lane and was also known as Anusilan Samiti. Later on, when it was shifted to Madan Mitra Lane, it came to be known as Anusilan Samiti, okay? Now you can see here, Arvindo Ghosh, okay? Arvindo Ghosh was sent from Baroda, okay? Arvindo Ghosh sent from Baroda, his emissary. What is the meaning of emissary? Messenger, okay? Emissary means messenger. Jainendra Nath Banerjee was sent by Arvindo Ghosh to go to Bengal and talk with the youths and mobilize the Bengal revolutionaries, make them understand and try to revolutionize their mind with revolutionary activities. Okay, so when he reached over there, he contacted with P.N. Mitra. Okay, Arvindo also sent his brother Barendra Nath to Calcutta to inspire revolution. That means these people, almost these important leaders, were involved in inspiring the revolutionaries in Bengal. Okay, it is mentioned. Arvindo also sent his brother Barendra Nath to Calcutta to inspire the revolutionaries. They were sent over there. Arvindo himself came to Bengal in 1904. So all these activities you can see here. If you read it, you'll understand the activities. Now you can see here. Now the most important fact of this part is over here. Jugantar group, or we can say Jugantar group. Now plan to assassinate the oppressive magistrate Kingsford, who has been transferred to Muzaffarpur from Bengal. Before he was in Bengal, now this Kingsford, magistrate Kingsford, now is transferred to Muzaffarpur. Okay, so the planning was to kill him. So Barendra Nath then commissioned two young youths at that time who were filled with the enthusiasm to do something for the country. They were Khudiram Bose. You might have heard about his name. Khudiram Bose and Prafulla Chakri. So they were given the responsibility or they were given the assignment to assassinate Kingsford at Muzaffarpur. They were sent to Muzaffarpur to kill the magistrate Kingsford. Okay, so their attempt failed, my dear. In spite of killing the main person, two English ladies were killed. Innocent people were killed. Okay, so in order to avoid a police arrest, Prafulla Chakki committed suicide. He himself killed. Okay, he killed himself. He committed suicide, and Khudiram was arrested and was put to trial and then hanged. Khudiram was arrested and trial took place, and later on he was hanged. Okay, so this is the first task been done by Yugandhar Group by Khudiram Bose and Prafulla Chakki. Okay, now you can see here their activities still continued in April 1908. In 1908, police discovered a secret bomb manufacturing factory at, okay, secret manufacturing factory at Murari Pukur. You can see here, Murari Pukur, Manik Tala area of Calcutta. So this was a secret area. Then the secret societies means, what is the meaning of secret society? They were hiding somewhere in some warehouses and training the revolutionaries and manufacturing bombs and all. That is why they were known as secret societies. So this led to a sensational arrest. When this bomb manufacturing factory was discovered, a sensational arrest took place. Okay, some of the hardcore revolutionaries, most important leaders, okay, revolutionary leaders like Aurobindo Ghosh and his brother Barendranath Ghosh were arrested. They were important. That means the boss of these revolutionaries were arrested. Okay, so when the trial took place, you know that the most important thing is that whoever is arrested, they have to go through a trial. So during the course of the trial, okay, the approver, the public prosecutor, the police officers were assassinated. Okay, those who were approver, those who, that means the public prosecutor who was fighting a case against them, they were killed. So most of the accused were convicted and sentenced to a long term imprisonment. Whoever were arrested that time, they were sentenced for a long term. You can see here, most of the accused were convicted and sentenced to long term imprisonment. Aurobindo Ghosh was finally acquitted because of brilliant pleading of his counsel, famous Chittaranjan Das. So his case was fought by Chittaranjan Das. At that time, he was popularly known as Yar Das. Okay. And Aurobindo Ghosh then retired from politics and devoted himself to the spiritual quest at Pondicherry. So anyhow, the revolutionary activities continued. So the motive of this chapter was to make you understand that till then, moderates, extremists, revolutionaries, they were not terrorists according to us, my dear. They were the one who were frustrated, okay, going through the work of moderates and the extremists. Do you understand? Now you can see here, another part is also there, Dhaka Anusilan Samiti, which was founded in the year 1905. And several branches were opened in different parts of East Bengal. So this Samiti carried out revolutionary activities with great enthusiasm. Okay, you can see here, Trailokyanath Chakravarti, Makhan Lal Sen, okay, Nalini Kant Ghosh were important members of the group. So you must remember these names. Okay. These are the names you have to remember, Ghosh. These three, Trailokyanath Chakravarti, Makhan Lal Sen, and Nalkant Ghosh were very, very important members of this group, Anusilan Samiti. From the very beginning of this organization, these people concentrated more on secret training of cadres to physical culture. Secret training was given to the cadres. Whoever were the members of this group, they were given secret training. Okay. So they also, this Samiti also made abortive efforts to assassinate Allen, the district magistrate of Dhaka. They tried to kill the district magistrate of Dhaka, but failed. Okay. And to blow up train in which Bengal Governor Fraser was traveling in 1907, two attempts. First one, First attempt also failed. Second attempt also failed. The first attempt was to assassinate Allen. He was the district magistrate of Dhaka. And the second was to blow up the train. They wanted to blow up the train in which Bengal Governor Fraser was traveling in 1907. Okay, children. So this is all about the secret societies and then groups. You can see here. Then likewise, my dear Abhinav Bharat and other societies. That means apart from Yugantar, Anusilan Samiti, many other secret groups were also there, which was sprouting its root in different parts of the country. You can see here, like Bengal. That means the revolutionaries were inspired from Bengal activities also. Like similar societies were formed in Bihar, Odisha, Punjab. Okay, in Bihar also, Odisha, Punjab, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, and Madras. Okay, so in Madras, Basudev Balwant Rao Phadke tried to organize armed insurrection by giving training to tribal classes. Then Damodar Balkrishnan Chapekar, two brothers, okay, Chapekar brothers, killed the oppressive plague commissioner Rande and his assistant August at Pune in 1897. Okay, so these were some of the activities being carried out by different secret societies operating in different parts of the country. Okay, now the last part, you can go through the assessment also. Okay, you can see here, to one more, the last paragraph, you can see here, the revolutionaries also set up centers outside India. Also revolutionary activities took place. You might have heard about the name, okay, B.D. Savarkar, Hardayal. Okay, they set up a secret association outside India also, that is in London. While Ajit Singh, Madam Kama became very active in Europe. That means activities, revolutionary activities were inspired outside India also. They were supporting the nationalistic movement going on in India. In 1909, Madan Lal Dhingra killed Mr. Wigley, an official of an Indian office in London. He was tried and hanged. Okay, so that was all about from this chapter. Let's